Okay. It may be yet another desktop files editor, but it's actually a good one, so don't skip. I'm gonna do it fast anyway. All right, here we are, and the first we're gonna do is to create a new desktop file for launching the Voicevox app image. Tap on plus icon, and this is basically a properties editor for XDG desktop file specifications, but it only lists a few entries, and it's up to us to add more if we need. Basically, what we only need is the app name aka Voicevox and the path of the executable. And some icon, maybe? I will discuss the broken thumbnails on GTK Picker another time, alright? Next, we can rename the file for easily recognize it, and that's saved on .local, share, and applications. Perhaps it could get the desktop file name from the application name, but it's okay. That's it, we are done. Hit back to actually create the file, and pin it! Which is a bit odd metaphor for manual desktop files, but whatever. The important thing is that we have our launcher ready and waiting, so let's get to the second thing we can do, overwriting existing applications. And most specifically, I want to hide an app that I'm not proud at all of having it. Really, anyone knows why the KDE Flatpak apps are so shitty with broken graphics and stuff in GNOME? Anyway, so let's suppose we want to hide Kwrite. And I say suppose because we actually want to completely remove it. But let's suppose we only want to hide it from the launcher for now. On the Boolean values, we can add a new key entry and give it the no display property. Enable this, and when we go back, the app will create a desktop file in XDG local path that takes priority. Meanwhile, the icon is a bit faded out so we can immediately tell this is a hidden entry. So, if we go back to shell launcher, Kwrite will now be missing. And that was pretty much everything. A desktop editor with an extra convenient UI, much unlikely with all the rest I've tried.
Toa koro sarereba shinu.